all of a sudden they said everybody should move out, all these things. The person said our house rent is expired.
Okay.
She discovered that we are Nigerian. Our wish, we want to pay our money.
Okay.
And they said they don't want Nigeria.
Yeah.
And we have a rest of mind.
Yeah.
No one is worrying us.
Yeah.
No one is stopping us. You can come in at any time, can go out at any time.
Hello, welcome to my channel once again. Today, I'm bringing you another video that I had an interview with a Nigerian who is currently in Ghana and working. He has been in Ghana for some time now. You know how I do it, interviewing them and knowing their experience in Ghana, sharing basically with us their experience in Ghana. So if you want to know what they said, stay tuned till the end and watch this video. Don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe, and comment whatever you want to comment. Let's go into the video.
Yeah, bro. Your name?
My name is Sam.
I came here, I saw that you are into phone repairs. This is like your stuff. This place that you are, where exactly are you? Like, if you are trying to direct people to this place, where exactly are you?
I'm at SWERU. Freddy's corner down.
Freddy's corner down.
Yeah. Got that up.
Okay, no problem. Like, what I would do is I will let you put your number down there so that in case if anybody wants your service, they will just do what contact you.
Okay. Nice.
But today we are talking about your journey. Actually, you are Nigerian, right?
Yes.
And when did you come to Ghana?
I come here going to 2 years now.
Going to 2 years. And my question is, why did you decide to come to Ghana? What made you come to Ghana?
Wow, that question. The reason why I left Nigeria is because of some family issue.
Family issue.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like when you see somebody that is worrying you, at least you have to give that person space.
Yeah.
That's what caused my own. I just space myself for some people.
Okay.
And that's why I come back.
Yeah, you come to Ghana.
That's it.
Yeah.
I didn't get a job. This is the only opportunity I have.
Okay.
It's repairing, which I have the knowledge of it before.
Okay.
And I have to move on with it.
Okay.
Yes. That's why I'm into the repair in Ghana.
Okay. My next question to you is, when you came, how was the reception? How did Ghana receive you? How has it been?
Actually, I come here on my own. I don't know nobody.
Like, you didn't know anybody?
I don't know anybody. I don't know anyone.
Okay.
I came on my own.
Okay.
Yeah. When I came, I saw someone that he helped me. Let me just say he helped me for some while.
You coming to Ghana, someone helped you because you didn't know anybody here?
Yes, he helped me with accommodation and stuff.
Okay.
For a little time.
Okay, so we'll say now you are okay, because as like you told me, you are working now, so you're like, you say you are okay now.
I'm actually okay. I can't say I'm not okay.
Yeah.
So
than before.
Than before.
Okay.
We are still looking out there for opportunity.
And definitely you need to strive for more. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
That's just it.
But as I asked you, how has Ghana been the 2 years that you have spent here? How has Ghana been actually for you? How has been the reception? Like, as I said, how has Ghanaians treated you and all that? I just want to know.
Ghana is good.
Okay.
It's good. It's a peaceful country.
Okay.
As I come here, I don't even expect what I see.
Oh, okay.
You have to take everything you see like that.
Okay.
But here is peaceful. I can do my thing on my own. I can no disturb.
Okay.
No one's worrying me, so I can do my thing on my own.
Okay.
That's just it. Not anything.
Okay. So right now, when you came from Nigeria, did you come straight to Accra or you went to other places before coming here?
When I come from Nigeria, I arrived at this thing, at Sprintex.
Sprintex, yeah, okay, that's
Accra, where I came to.
Okay.
So after some months where I live from Accra.
Okay. Sprinters is part of, even Sprinters, I don't know whether Tema
part
or
of Tema.
Yeah. Like it's part of Tema. Sprinters is part of Tema.
Yes.
But Tema and like Tema is also part of Greater Accra. So same Greater Accra.
Yeah, it's the same place.
Yeah, the same Greater Accra. So now you are in Circle, that's where you are. What has been some of the challenges that you faced when you came here to Ghana? Definitely.
Lot.
Within these 2 years, you face some challenges. So can you just share with us?
A lot.
Okay, so give us about three challenges that you faced.
The challenges, most challenges is accommodation challenges.
Accommodation.
When you don't know.
Or what happens?
Yes.
Like when you want accommodation.
Like the person I spot with.
Okay.
Later he told me that okay. The house rent is expired, which I don't know. I'm not aware before. So all of a sudden he said everybody should move out, all these things. The person said our house rent is expired.
Yeah.
And they need to do renovation for the house too.
Okay.
So that's how we scatter from the house. Everybody left. And from there I don't know where to go.
Okay.
I have to go and meet some Ghanaian, some people to just help me out. Like I sleep here today, sleep there tomorrow. But I don't even get job.
Okay.
Just accommodation.
Like at that time?
Yes. Just to sleep and wake up. That's what I want that time.
Okay.
Before God provide some brother for me, that person helped me.
Okay.
Before I get a job.
So
my challenges is just accommodation, because
just accommodation.
Yes, because we don't know anybody here, so it's just accommodation.
But you know, in Ghana we have this saying that most Nigerians, when they go to rent houses or rooms or apartments or whatever, it's difficult for them because the moment the landlord gets to know that they are Nigerians, they don't want to give it to, they don't want to give their apartment to them. Have you ever experienced that thing before?
Yes, I experienced that too. Because when me and my guys, when we left the office, because we call the office, we gather ourselves to go and take apartment, maybe one room or safe car.
Okay.
When we get there, the woman, because she's landlady, she discovered that we are Nigerian, of which we want to pay our money.
Okay.
And he said they don't want Nigeria to rent his house, they want Ghana. Because we don't hear tree, we don't hear Hausa, we don't hear any language.
Any language,
so
any Ghanaian language.
Yes. So we can't make it because we can't speak any language. That's the reason why the woman said no, they can't give us the house. We should go and find our own house. That's where the difficulty starts. Starts in the streets.
Okay. Asking you about the challenges, can you share with us some of the good moments that you have had experience, like since you came to Ghana? Like you say, oh, I really love this about this country, or I experienced this thing as like it's very nice.
Yeah.
So like, can you give us like two experiences?
For my own experience, the first one, because when I came to Ghana, I still have some change with me.
Yeah.
Then me and my friends, we always flex.
Okay.
Because we always flex.
Okay.
Enjoy, go to beach, go Sakumono. That time, Sprinters.
Okay.
Sakumono is not far from us. That's where we go and chill, enjoy ourselves, and then we come back home.
Okay.
And again, let me just say, when we get apartment, when we are in our own house, and we have a rest of mind, no one is worrying us, no one is stopping us. You can come in at any time, can go out at any time. So that one will make Ghana free for us, like we enjoy Ghana for that, and the lights.
Yes,
most important thing is the lights. That's what Nigerians are enjoying
in Ghana.
So that's why they came.
Okay. Since you came to Sprinters and you moved to Circle, where again have you traveled to in Ghana?
Yeah, I traveled.
So where have you gone to?
I went to Fota region side.
Fota region, Pando, okay.
And I went to this side. What's it called? Kufurudia.
Okay.
That's the only two far places
that you need to travel to. But when you came, have you tried our local dishes? 2 years in here, you have to.
Nah.
You haven't.
None of the food.
Yeah. So what do you? I'm trying. So like, what do you eat in Ghana?
Bro, there's a lot of food. We Nigerians too, we are making our food in Ghana yet.
So yeah, I know that you have some restaurants around.
Yeah, you can locate Nigeria kitchen.
Food, yeah, a lot.
So that one there, I don't have problem with food.
So you
only once I take NK and the KK forged me.
Yeah,
so that's
forged
I did,
you.
Yeah, that's why I didn't take again. Ghana dishes again because I don't know what will happen next.
Oh, but maybe if you try another dish, maybe KK.
No, I've tried.
It's not good for you. You tried banku and you liked it all.
Yeah, yeah, I like the banku.
So what of fufu?
Fufu, yes, I eat the fufu. Too.
And gobe too.
I don't know what is gobe.
Gobe is beans. Beans, okay. And gari and red oil and red plantain.
That one there, I love beans.
You love beans, so
yes, I always eat beans.
So what of wache too?
Wache, I don't like wache.
You don't like wache? Yeah.
No, you sound
serious. Okay. I think you have quite a little experience though, but I think we will take it. 2 years is not too long. So maybe as time goes on, you will get to experience a lot of
that's my
things in the country. But what about our girls?
Hey, I don't even get time for girls in Ghana. You
are
know.
You sure?
Yes, I don't have girls.
Hey, so you've not had any eye for any Ghana girl?
Nah.
Hey. Are you sure? Your eyes and circle here, so many girls will be walking passing by and all that. You've not.
And they are passing, but we are watching with our eye.
That's all. You don't take action.
No. We don't take action. We are just watching.
Okay. No problem. What I want you to do right now is you are into phone repairs.
Yeah.
At Circle. And what I want you to do is I want you to put your number out there for anyone who also wants to repair their phones. They can. What and what do you do actually? Apart from repairing phones, that's the only thing you do.
That's not my only profession.
Okay.
My profession is construction.
Construction, okay.
Yeah. But as I come Ghana here,
yeah,
I don't have the link.
Okay.
So I have to do the work.
Focus
now.
On the yes. phone the one, repairs
that
before.
That is the only available work I have. So I have to focus on it.
On the phone repairs.
Yes, that's why I focus on the phone repairs.
Okay.
And I don't know if I get the opportunity of that construction too in Ghana yet. I will go there.
Okay.
Yeah. That's just it.
Okay. Just put your number out there in case anyone wants to repair their phones. They can contact you and
yeah,
you help
not
them.
The problem.
Yeah. So give them your number.
0260.
0260.
730.
730.
25.
25.
64.
64.
Okay. 0
okay,
2 6
wait.
0
start again.
0260 730
okay
2564 yes.
Okay, mention it again, the last one.
So 0260
okay
730
okay
2564
64 okay. All right, thank you so much for this interview, and I'm sure people who also need your services will call you for you to repair your stuff for them. So
thank you very much.
You're
I really appreciate it.
All right.